One of the great things about the AutoStore is that you can have it swallow building columns and stuff. The building column is surrounded by the technology, the robots work their way around it, everything is good, you don't have to think about it anymore. That's a real advantage of some of the other technologies. Another advantage is you inherently, because you don't have aisles and you don't need to have spaces between aisles of product, you can pack product much more closely together. Why that matters is, have you ever heard of cheap retail space? You don't have cheap retail space. So, and the more you want to have these kind of services closer to customers, the more expensive your retail space is. So now you're dealing with whatever other obstructions, you're dealing with buildings that are L-shaped maybe, or you're dealing with odd ceiling configurations and things like that. And the AutoStore allows you to accommodate those probably better than almost any other technology around. So that's a real advantage. The other thing that people worry about is it translates in technology speak, it's uptime. To you, if you're making a decision as a grocery company, if you're making a decision, what uptime really means to you is, if a piece of this fails or if it sits down, am I going to be affected by it? Because I've got somebody who's driving to this location to pick up the grocery and you can't afford to have that interruption. And is it going to really slow me down? One of the challenges with aisle-based technologies is you've got a limited number of robots that do the work, and there's a few points, single points of failure. Again, a little bit of industry jargon. All that means is if one piece goes down, it has a negative effect that goes across a large portion, if not the entire system. One of the advantages of AutoStore is that it has distributed robots. It's got a bunch of robots. They all feed off the same area. Think of a bunch of seagulls feeding after stuff on a beach or on a fishing dock, but you've got a whole bunch of robots that are sort of feeding in the same area. If one of them stops, there's plenty of other robots. You just reassign the work, it's all done by software, and then the work gets done. The robot that is sitting down gets taken off and there's some maintenance and everything else just continues as normal. There aren't single points of failure. So now your customer who's driving there and is pulling in the next few minutes isn't compromised. You're not dealing with headaches from a management point of view. Your customer service people are happy.